everyone. Please subscribe to our channel if you find this is useful, and let your friends also know about our channel. So in this one, we are going to see the different strategy. This is not strategy. Normally, if you follow this, you can easily sustain in the market. Like, you need to invest with stop loss and trade without stop loss. So this looks like odd, because normally people used to tell you can invest and leave it like that. But while you are trading without stop loss, if you trade, it is like a suicide. But we are telling in an opposite way. So just look into the points what we need to follow for our in the market. What we need to follow in the market. Let us look some of the points over there. So what is the first mistake actually we are doing while doing the investing? For example, if someone has 1 lakh or even 10,000, some 100 rupees worth stock, if suddenly got rising, what people will do? They will invest their whole amount just for buying that stock. So after that, the stock will start falling. So now they are not ready to come out with loss also, because they put all their money, like for example 100 and 1000 stocks, even if it come by 10 rupees, so they will be in a loss of 10,000. So they are not ready to book the loss of 10,000. In addition to that, and because of that, after that, if they see some opportunity in some other stocks or some other thing, they cannot invest or do some trading, because they put all their money in a single stock at a single shot. So now even they know, okay, this stock will not go up, they are not ready to book their loss, because they saw in front of their eyes 10,000 loss. So they are not ready to book that loss. So it will keep on go down, and for example certain points it will come to some 50 rupees. Then people will think, okay, if I buy 1000 more stocks or 100 over what they did already, 100 stocks or 1000 stocks, they will add some 1000 more stocks and make it to average to 75,000. If we ask them, they will tell, okay, now only 25,000, 25 points out of my investment cost. So if 25 points more, I will come out with my cost. So even if it goes down further, they will again add on the down stock. That is the main reason for the loss for main people. Even some of them will tell, after 1 or 2 years, it will reach their 75 or the first investment of 100, and it will reach that 100. They will come out and tell that, okay, I got my investment back. How is it? Because in 2 years, you lost some amount because of inflation. For example, after 2 years, 1 lakh is equal to 90,000. That doesn't mean you get back your money back. Even if you consider just you put your money 1 lakh in the FD, you will get at least 6% return. You will be in a profit of 12,000. So it doesn't mean even if it reach your price or 100 also, you didn't get your money back. And that time the stock will keep on moving up, but they will come out, okay, at least finally I saw my amount, I need to come out, and they will come out, then it stock will go up. While it is going down, they are ready to invest. But while it is coming up and even ready to cross their level, they are happy with their amount, just they will come out. This is the main mistake the investors used to do. So what we need to do, see, very simple thing. You no need to know the fundamental or anything about any stocks. Just good stock, like for example ITC, Dabur, or some pharma stocks, anyhow, that is not very bad. Suddenly it will not go like to the zero or something. Just take that stock. If you are planning to buy some 100 stocks, just start with 5 stock or at the max 10 stocks in that one. So from your point, if it start moving up, then add some 5 more stocks. Then if it is moving above, 5 more stocks. Okay, then if it is start coming down, first book your first 5 stock which is in profit, just come out. The next, it's little bit more, okay, come out for the last 5, sorry, the second 5. So even after it come down, so no need to invest, just let the 5 stock be there. Then after that, the market or that stock, after hitting some level or somewhere, it is start reversing back, then start 5 stock, and if it is moving above 5 stock. So what you need to do is simple, 1/10th or 1/20th of stock, you need to invest at the initial stage, because even though if it is going against you, just you can come out, because you will not be in a big loss. For example, if you planning to buy some 100 stocks worth of 100 rupees, instead of that, if you buy 10 stocks out of 10 stocks with the cost of 100, and if it moves to 90 also, your loss is only 100 rupees. So you will not worry about your loss, just you will come out. Even for 1000 stocks also, your loss, 100 stocks also, your loss will be 1000 instead of 10,000 if you go by all 1000 stocks. Then what you can do? You can do trade in another stock or invest in this same one while it is start coming back. So this will give you the direction. If you go with the low quantity or low amount, then you will not be just you will not love your stock, or somebody will become, for even many people like Yes Bank, even it is very penny stock going down, people are ready to invest on that one. So why? Lot of many good stocks are there, but they will keep on averaging, even Arcom, many stocks, it went to the down, but still people are holding that one. It will come back, but it will never come back. Or you can use some strategy. You might have follow our channel for long time. You know we always use the strategy, and we did for long time, like buying the stock and selling the long call option. We did this one for 4 to 5 times for Bajaj Finance, and 2 to 3 times for IndusInd Bank, Reliance, and for Sun Pharma, even Aurobindo Pharma, and many stocks we did, and we even Reliance, we came out with good profit in that one. The logic is simple, like you need to take the maximum long call. Like for example, now the Reliance is trading around 2000, or for example Bajaj Finance, which is trading around 3500, we need to sell some 4000 or 4200 call. But sometimes that much level will not run in the market, but at least 3900 or 4000 call, and you need to buy 10 to 20 stocks. So at each move up level, you need to add 10 more stocks. So before it reaching that level, you need to have equivalent of the option value. Like for Bajaj Finance, we have 250, so we need to have some 250 stocks. What is the disadvantage of this? The cost is very high. Everyone cannot work on this one, but winning ratio is very high, because we did this one, even we did that time Bajaj Finance was trading around 2200, and 3000 call was trading around 40 rupees, so nearly 10,000 worth of call option was trading around 3000, which is 30% away from the market price. So it is not possible in a month or 2 weeks time reaching that 3000. So that time we sold many times, and we booked the profit at that time. Even if it is move on our direction also, there is no problems, because at every 20 points we are going to add, or every 50 points we are going to add some 10 more stocks. While it reach that level, our average price will be 2600. So if you have 200 stocks also, we will be in a profit of 80,000, and after that, for each, whichever the movement it is going up, the stock will take care of that one, because equivalent amount of stock we have. So we can do that one for all stocks also, but certain stocks will not be very active, like so we need to select like Reliance or SBI, ICICI, like these stocks we can do. And one more simple strategy, just what we told right already, like see, you need to buy some stocks, even 1/10th of the stock for 100 rupees. If it come to 90 rupees, just come out. Even after reaching 90, it can go to 120 or 150, whatever it may be. But from 100, if it touches 90, just come out and wait, unless until it return back, or we can invest in some other stock. So the one you are going to invest, If it goes below 10% of your investment price, just come out. So this will first avoid your maximum loss. Then your mind will be free, you will be concentrate on other stock or whichever you want to invest. Because just if you will focus on only one stock, and even if it is going down also you are not coming out, you will not think out of the box or what is going on outside. Even the market is falling like anything, you will not see that one, because even that is the reason for your stock fall also. But you will not ready to come out if you invest all your amount in one stock at a single shot. So always go with 1/10, and even if it goes below some 10% loss, just come out from your position. So this is one way of avoiding your big loss. See, for example, very simple thing, just you can use any indicator. See, because you, the people, those who have watched our video, we never use any indicator for trading, only the levels. But if you are not comfortable with levels, see, why we are not using indicator is, indicator will show you which direction the stock is going, but during the trading time it will not give you the perfect indication, because it will follow the charts. Like, see, for example, it is going up, the indicator also will come behind that one. See, before that one, by looking itself we can identify it is moving above. But for investment, just we can use, see, for example, just take, because I didn't do anything, this is just for example, okay, just by default it come 50 day moving average, just take this one. See, if it is above 50 day moving average on a weekly basis or monthly basis, just keep on invest one stock. If it is like here, see, if you have some 4 to 5 stock at this level, and if it is going to cut this one, at that time if you have 5 stock, just sell 2 or 3 stocks whichever in profit, like, because in the average price anyway we will be in profit here. Just you can sell 2 to 3 stocks. That remaining 2 stocks also, from this level, if it goes below 10% of our investment cost, just come out and wait. See, after that we got the opportunity here. So invest one stock here, and then invest one stock here, and then invest one stock here. Now we are above 50 day moving average. So we are going to keep on adding one stock on a monthly or a weekly basis, when this is daily candle. So it is nearly 2 months of rally. So if you buy one here and maybe buy one more here, for example, this is 2600 around. So here we can take this one, like 3000 here. So you are investing here one, here one. So your investment cost is now 2800 only. So two stocks are at the profit of 3400. Even if you invest one more here, your average cost will come around 3000. So even these three stocks are in profit of like 400 rupees. So if it is keep on moving, we will add one. The simple logic is always add or invest in the stocks if it is keep on moving above. Never average when it is going down. If you follow this, you can easily win. That is why in our logic, the only concern is the cost. But in the future, if you have the cost, you can do that one. So for example, in our strategy, we are keep on adding 10 stocks or 20 stocks if the stock is keep on going up. So in two ways we are in profit, because like our average is keep on adding when the stock is going above, so our average cost also will be in positive. In addition to that, we will get money from option selling also. So that is why that strategy is a very good strategy, except the cost. That same way, even if we cannot do that one, just you can add one stock and one, you can keep on going. So okay, one day it is come down, and at that time if this one 50 day moving average is trading here, and try to cut, you have some 3 to 4, just come out 2, and then wait for some time. If it is going down and start crossing above this one over here some level, then start invest again 1 or 2, like that. So always you can keep your strategy whichever it is comfortable for you. See, you cannot do this thing also, like in the Nifty 50, like Reliance or HDFC Bank are very good stock, right? Because they are the base for the Nifty. So take like that stock, some 10 stocks. So if Nifty is above the 50-day moving average or 200, whichever it is comfortable, you can take that. And in addition to that, in the 10 stock, whichever the stock is crossing above 50-day moving average, just invest only on that stock. If it is come down, just come out of that one. So the next day, some 4 to 5 stocks above that level, just you can invest on that one. So you need to add only whichever it is above your level. So if you do this, you will never lose in the stock market. So this for investing. Let us look for some of the methods for trading. See, we told trade without stop loss. Somebody asked me, okay, if you told trade without stop loss, it is like a suicide. Like if I have some 10,000 and if I bought, or 1 lakh, if I bought options for 1 lakh and without stop loss, there is a more possibility that it can go into zero. See, if I told trade without stop loss, see, for example, you are buying some 10 lots worth of some 100, just take like that in option 75,000, and you put 10 rupees as stop loss, so risk of 7,500. Instead of that one, just buy only one option worth of 100 and just leave that. Even if it go to 80 and it can reach 200 also. But if you put some strict stop loss which is near to your buying price, like somebody will buy 100 and put stop loss around 96. So most probably it will hit and go above, or it will hit and go down, that is different. But 4 rupees, most probably it will easily hit. So better than that, you can serve, for example, 10 stocks with 10 option with 4 points. You can buy only one option worth of 40 rupees and just leave that. Even if it becomes zero also, no problem. But if it is in your favor, either it can go to 100 or 120. So when compared to that one, this will give you better return. Or if you are a risk taker, just for example, you can buy 11,200 call and sell 11,300 call option, or 11,200 put option and sell 11,100 put option. So if this one is trade around 100 and that one will trade around 70. So the risk reward ratio also very high, because if you lose, you lose only 30 points. But if you gain, you will gain around 70 points, and you have no need to worry also daily. You no need to watch, or like a weekly option you bought, okay, up to next week you have time. See, for example, for 2 days there is no movement in the option also, no need to worry, because if 100 become 80, your 70 become 50 or 45, so 20 to 25 points will covered by your selling option. So your risk is keep on mitigated if you do like this strategy. So try or find new things or good strategy which is used for you, but never trade with stop loss. Okay, you can trade with stop loss, but it need to be little bit long. For example, for 100 rupees worth stock, it needs to be around 10. But that doesn't mean you need to buy 1,000 stocks and keep 10 rupees as a stop loss. Then the loss will be like 10,000. So if you have 1 lakh, then you can buy only 100, and at the max you can put 90 rupees as stop loss. Then if the stock is keep on moving 102, 104, then you need to move to 94, 96, 98. Then that time that 96 or 98 will work. Just you buy 1,000 stocks around for 100 and put 98 as stop loss, it will easily hit and then it will move. So keep your stop loss away. So if the market reverses or the stock reverses while you watching itself, you can come to know. So manually just you can come out from the market. And you no need to worry, because you are like only 10 stocks or 50 stocks if you buy, then even stop loss is little bit higher also. The loss will be like 200 or 300. So we will not worried or think about that one, and we will take that cost from another trade. But if you have long, big amount of investment over in the market, then if it is going near to that one, we will keep on moving the stop loss, and finally it will be in a big loss. And this already we used to tell, like, don't trade by getting tips, because the people will easily cheated us. Like, see, for example, some stock is moving very fast and it is moving from 100 to 102, 104, and they will just send a message to us like, okay, buy at 102. While we're getting the message itself, already it will reach 104 or 106. Then after, sometimes they will send us the mail, sell at 106. That time that stock will reach 100 or 102. So we will buy at 104 and sell at 102. But they will tell, see, the stock moves, but you didn't pick at the right time. That is your fault, not our fault. And one more set of people is there. The strategy is very simple. They will ask the people, see, we are not the group, just we will get the money and cheat you. We are a true tips provider. Like, if you get the profit, in that profit, just 20% profit amount give to us. No need to pay the amount in the previous itself. So whatever people think, okay, these are genuine people, then they will collect such people, some around 1,000 people. And what they will do, they will divide into 500 and 500. So they will give for 500 people call option, for 500 people put option. Then if the market goes up, the call people will get good profit and the put people will be in loss and they will not contact them. And they will also quit because these people are not a genuine provider. But the people from 500 call option they gave, right? So from them they will get the money. Then again they will split them into two, like 250, 250. Again they will give the same strategy like call and put. Then again from the people, those who are winning, they will get the strategy. So unless until they will nullify, they will get the money from the people and they will run away. So never get tips for trading. This is the main thing in trading. And if you trade frequently, just buy and sell, buy and sell, buy and sell, finally, even though the day end you are in a profit of 1,000, your brokerage will be 2,000 or something, or sometimes even equivalent. So finally you are fight with the market to earn money for the broker, not for you. So you need to earn money for you, not for the broker. Just keep that one in mind and never trade on frustration. Or if you fight to recover your loss, like, okay, I lost 300, I need to get back, so double your lot. Then again 1,000 loss, then 2,000. Then next day you will come out with more loss. Then finally you will end up with nothing, and again you will add more amount, that amount also will go, because you are fighting with the market. Never fight with market. Do trade as trade, okay? If it either hit stop loss or my target, that's it. If either of that one hit, just come out and don't fight with market. I need to earn from the market, just like that. This is another. So if you follow these things in trading or in investing, you will certainly win in the market. So these are all some key points. The you don't do such things like, see, for example, you need to decide whether you are going to trade or for investment. See, for example, some people will go for trade and buy some 100 stock, and if the stock goes down, then they will change into investing because they don't want to book their losses. So they will convert into investing. See, for investing, the strategy is different because you need to check the levels or the chart, whether it is going up or not. For trading, on the day, maybe that stock is going up, that is why we are going to buy, but suddenly it changes. But that doesn't mean we need to convert this one into investing, because for long term, either it may be a good stock or fundamental or something, it will not be suit for that stock. Or somebody will do investment, like they will buy the stock. In 2 minutes, the stock will come to 98, then they will ping many people and ask the lead or whoever in the YouTube, okay, I bought this stock, it came to 98, whether I hold or not. See, if it is an investment, it needs to be for 10 years. At least for worst case, 2 to 3 years, you should not have to think. If you buy some fundamental stock like Dabur or ITC or some good stock, if you are worried about 2 rupees in 15 minutes, then you will not suit for investing, even for trading also. So you need to decide on what purpose you are buying and whether trading or investing it suits for you. You need to decide that thing. Without that thing, just like that, okay, everyone is doing trading or investing, we will also need to do, then you will be in failure. Such people will come out of the market and they will tell, market is like a gambling, you cannot win in the market, it is not a easy thing, or blah blah blah, something they will always comment on market. So still some people are running their life just by trading or by investing from the market itself. So it depends on you, how hard work or how much time you put on this one. Just like that, you will come and you cannot earn from stock market. So just follow these points and update me how it works. So if you like this video, please subscribe and let your friends also know about our channel. Thank you.